folks, welcome back to another Top 10 List of the Dice Tower. Today we're taking a look at Clank, my top 10 favorite cards in Clank. Now this includes stuff from the Sunken Treasure and the Mummy's Curse expansions, so there's a lot of different things, and it does not include Clank in Space, a different game, or Clank Legacy, because I don't want to spoil any of those cards. But I will say, if I was picking 10 favorite cards, they would all come from Clank Legacy, but there's a lot of customization of cards involved there. That being said, here are my 10 favorite cards from Clank and why. Let's get started. All right, we'll start with one here from Sunken Treasures. This is the Boomerang. I really like the Boomerang. It's fairly inexpensive, and it gives you one buying power and two attack. Pretty handy card to have. And if you're ever forced to discard it, it comes back in your hand, which is a pretty cool thing. Just keep using the Boomerang over and over and over again. Number 9. This is from the Mummy one, the Bullwhip. Now, part of this is I like it thematically. You know, hey, I'm using Indiana Jones whip. That's what it is, right? But the diversity of it. Now, it does give you one clank, but for 3, I don't care. I'll take the clank to be able to move, attack, and have some purchasing power. Number 8 is Shortcut. I like Shortcut. It's pretty simple. When you buy it, you get a move. It is one move. And when you discard it, 2 more move. Now, it does give you an extra clank, but in the game of Clank, that usually doesn't bother me too much. I'll gladly do it. All right, next we have the Duke. The Duke is worth a point at the end of the game for every 5 gold you have, and he makes you just want to start hoarding gold. Hey, get a lot of gold. Take a pile of gold. You know, hoard up this gold. Don't spend it on items because it makes it worth points, and then he's worth 2 buying power and 2 attack, so I find him to be very handy. And then if you can combine him with my next favorite card, the Treasure Map, which just gives you 5 gold, this is worth it. If I can ever afford this card, when this pops up, I always buy the Treasure Map. So it's really simple. Gives you a pile of gold. Try to play this one a lot. It's worth it. I think the next card is a promo card, Wishing Well. It's a choose card. And if you know me at all, you know I like these. Choose card. You choose 2 of these. Trash a card in your play area or discard pile. Or 2 fight, 2 move, or heal 1. To be able to do that twice, very, very handy thing to have. I like it a lot. Then we have the Flying Carpet, another 6 cost card. This one lets you move 2, and you ignore monsters and tunnels, and you don't have to stop in crystal caves. This is an amazing card. If you get this, your movement becomes unbelievable. I'm not sure how Flying Carpet helps you move through a dungeon, but let's not dwell on the details. You'll notice I do like movements. My number 3, this one I like because economically it's an amazing card. It costs 1. And then it lets you do -2 clank, move, or take a coin. For a 1 cost card, and then you have the choice, and all 3 of those choices are worth it, I love this card. I've never seen anyone not buy this card. Usually you have 1 left over and you're really happy with it. My number 2 favorite card, hey. Now there are several cards that let you teleport to an adjacent room, but you're usually one-time use. This one you can keep using over and over again. Yes, it gives you a clank. Who cares? Skipping, one-way arrows, skipping monsters, not worrying about things. Just being able to teleport to an adjacent room is fantastic. I love the teleport action, and that's why it's my number 2. And my number 1 favorite card from Clank is the simple Move Silently. 2 movement, -2 clank. So great. If I can, so I said as I went through these cards that I don't mind the extra clank that I get from cards. And that's true to some degree. But if I can get that extra clank and then have a card like Move Silently, it balances out amazingly and I'm running through the dungeon like a demon. So that's my number 1 card, Move Silently. So there you go, those are my favorite cards from Clank, a deck building adventure game. So much fun, this game. You start with a deck of cards and you're going through a dungeon, kind of pushing your luck. If you've never played it, this will be an interesting video for you to watch, but it is an amazingly fun game. I really like it. Those are my 10 favorite cards. What are yours? Let me know in the comments. But until next time, I'm Tom Vasel, and you've been watching the top 10 cards from Clank.